Hello everyone, today we are going to study secondary messengers or second messengers. It is a part of signal transduction. As we know, plant receptor initiate signaling pathway. Not only that, but they oftenly generate secondary messengers. These secondary messenger passes signals from receptors to the signal transducers in cytosol. This secondary messenger not only passes the message from one molecule to other, but also amplifies the strength of signals. There are three classes of secondary messengers reported. First, that is cyclic nucleotide. Second, inositol triphosphate. And the third one, that is calcium ion. So, in this module, we are going to study different types of secondary messengers in plants and also the functioning of these secondary messenger in signal transduction pathways. Learning objectives of these modules are introduction of secondary messengers, types of second messengers in plants. Introduction. Multicellular organisms cannot survive without efficient communication among cells, tissues, and organs. Regulation and coordination of metabolism, growth, morphogenesis depends on chemical signals from one part of the plant to the another. German botanist Julius von Schuch is credited for originating this idea in the late 19th century. Typically, end result of any signaling pathways is alteration in gene expression via regulating the transcription factors. Signal transduction pathways often involve the generation of second messengers, transient secondary signals inside the cell that greatly amplify the original signal. Binding to a receptor initiate signal transduction pathways often involving the generation of second messengers such as cyclic nucleotide, inositol triphosphate and calcium. Such pathways normally lead to changes in gene expression. Chemical signals specifically bind proteins receptors found either on the plasma membrane or in the cell's cytoplasm. Second messengers are molecules that rely signals received at the receptors on the cell surface. These intracellular messengers have some properties in common. They can be synthesized or released and broken down again in specific reactions by enzymes or ion channels. Some, such as calcium ion, can be stored in a specific or special organs and quickly released when needed. Their production or release and destruction can be localized, enabling the cell to limit space and time of signal activity. These are the types of second messengers in plants. Types of second messengers in plants: 3,5 cyclic AMP, 3,5 cyclic GMP, nitric oxides, cyclic ADP ribose, 1,2 diglycerol, that is DAG, inositol, 1,4,5 triphosphate, that is IP3, and calcium ion. This slide showing chemical structure of secondary messengers. In that, we have seen cyclic AMP structure, cyclic GMP, cyclic ADP ribose, 1,2 diglycerol, inositol triphosphate, nitric oxide, and calcium ion. 3,5 cyclic AMP, that is CAMP. Adenosine 3,5 monophosphate, commonly known as CAMP, is a key second messenger in living organism ranging from Dictyostelium to Homo sapiens. CAMP was first described as a regulator of glycogen breakdown in the liver and is now known to be a second messenger for a wide variety of cellular responses in animals. 3,5-cyclic GMP. It has been shown that the second messenger cyclic glucosamine 3,5-monophosphate, that is cGMP, is an important signaling component with multiple biological functions in plant similar to the situation in animals. In plants, there is some biochemical evidence supporting the existence of plant cGMP responsive kinases. And in the Arabidopsis genome contains sequence that encodes gene product with both a cyclic nucleotide binding domain and a protein kinase. However, specific cGMP targets in plants are largely known, and in particular, there is little molecular evidence available of bona fide cGMP dependent kinases. 3,5-cyclic GMP signaling system consists of a signal protein membrane, guanylate cyclase. The inhibiting enzyme is cGMP phosphodiesterase. The effector protein is PKG. cGMP serve as a second messenger in a vertebrate's eye. It converts the visual signal, that is photons, to nerve impulses. This is the example in animal system where cGMP serve as second messenger in a vertebrate eye. It converts the visual signals, photons, to nerve impulses. Nitric oxide. Nitric oxide has multifunctional role in plants, stomatal movement, host pathogen interactions, hormonal signalings during growth and development, and adaptation to abiotic biotic stress. Nitrogen oxide is a guard cells plays a very important role as a secondary messenger during stomatal closure induced by effectors. Nitric oxide is a potent dormancy releasing agent in many species including Arabidopsis and has been suggested to behave as an endogenous regulator of these physiological blockages. Distinct reports have also highlighted a positive impact of nitrogen oxide on seed germination under suboptical conditions. However, its molecular mode of action in the context of seed biology remains poorly documented. This review aims to focus on the implication of this radical in the control of seed dormancy and germination. The schematic diagram summarizes nitrogen oxide signaling in seeds from generation to the targets. Nitrogen oxide can be produced by various biosynthesis pathways or released from nitrogen oxide storage compounds. The proteins are preferably targeted by nitrogen oxide, resulting in PTMS, that is cysteine S nitrosylation, tyrosine nitration, and metal nitrosylation. Mediated PTMS modulate the protein functions, leading to storage impact on cell metabolism, thereby affecting seed physiology. Here we can see nitrogen oxide and its function in seed dormancy and abiotic and biotic stress tolerance. Nitric oxide is hydrophobic gaseous molecule involved in various physiological processes such as germination, root growth, stomatal closure, control of the flowering timing, etc. Nitrogen oxide also functions as cell signaling molecule in plants and play important role in the regulation of plant responses to both abiotic and biotic stresses condition. At the molecular level, nitrogen oxide signaling include protein modification by binding to critical cysteine residues, heme or iron sulfur centers, and tyrosine residues to nitration via peroxynitrate formation, that is ONOO, mobilization of secondary messengers like CA2B, cyclic GMP, and cyclic ADP formation, cyclic ADP rib, and modulation of protein kinase activities. In plant, nitrogen oxide is a key component in cell's tolerance to oxidative stress, and this probably involves the enhanced expression of gene encoding antioxidant enzymes. Several studies have shown that exogenous nitrogen oxide ameliorate the oxidative stress induced by a range of biotic stress conditions. No exerts protective function against oxidative stress through the reaction with lipid radicals, which stops the propagation of lipid oxidation. Secondly, scavenging O2 and ONOO, thus neutralizing other cellular processes. Thirdly, activation of antioxidant enzyme, for example, superoxide dismutase, that is SOD, then catalyzes ascorbate peroxidase, guaiacyl peroxidase, that is GPX, and glutathione reductase, that is GR, functioning as a signaling molecule in the cascade of events leading to change in gene expression. Since nitrogen oxide is such an intriguing molecule, compelling research has been done to better understand nitrogen oxide biosynthesis and its role in signaling processes under stress condition. So, this figure shows the possible mechanism of nitrogen oxide induced oxidative stress protection. A schematic representation overlaying the present hypothesis indicating that nitrogen oxide is an endogenous signal that mediates responses to several stimuli is outlined in the figure. Extensive evidences showing that NO stimulates cGMP formation and cGMP dependent pathways exist in plants. The cGMP dependent signaling is a well-studied secondary messenger and a biologically active intracellular signaling molecule whose concentrations changes rapidly in response to external stimuli. The cGMP concentrations is increased by accelerated guanosyl cyclase, that is GC activity, enzyme involved in cGMP synthesis starting from guanosine triphosphate, that is GTP, which is shown in figure, that Donaldson et al. Reported that the stress-induced ABA synthesis caused a rapid increase in the cGMP content of Arabidopsis seedlings. It would appear that although an elevated level of cGMP is required for effective ABA-induced stomatal closure, additional signaling pathway must operate in concert for such increase to mediate its effects. It was also reported that nitrogen oxide may act through cGMP and CADPR to modulate intracellular CA2B permeable channels in order to elevate free systolic CA2B level in the cell. In Arabidopsis, cGMP synthesis is also required during NO-induced PCD, which is shown, the CADPR synthesis can be also inactivated by nitrogen oxide potentially via activation of cGMP-dependent kinases, similar to its interaction with GC. Nitrogen oxide can complex with Fe in other heme and Fe-containing proteins. Besides cGMP-dependent signaling, the cGMO-dependent signaling can be also considered, although its biochemical mechanism are not completely understood. Calcium ion-mediated signaling processes are also found to be functionally interconnected with NO signaling. For instance, concurrent increases in nitrogen oxide concentration and free cytosolic Ca2b level were found to occur during signal transduction initiated by abiotic and biotic stress. Figure shows nitric oxide signaling networks in plants. Cyclic ADP ribose, that is CADPR. There is a wide range of physiological functions are signaled and regulated by mobilization of intracellular calcium ion stores. The generally accepted view is that cells possesses multiple types of stores that can be mobilized by specific messengers molecules. Two unrelated nucleotides with calcium ion mobilizing activity was identified, for example, cyclic ADP ribose and nicotinic acid adenine nucleotide phosphatase. The action of CADPR on the channel is temperature dependent and proposed to be as temperature sensing mechanism in cells. Figure shows schematic representation of microinjection experiments to measure ABA-induced gene expression. Abscisic acid ABA controls plant responses to an array of environmental stresses, including drought, salinity, and cold, and thus elucidating its signal transduction pathway. It's fundamental to an understanding of stress physiology. Little is known about ABA perception, and no receptor has yet been identified. However, one step in the signal transduction pathway that appear to be common to ABA-regulated processes as diverse as gene expression and stromatal closure is an increase in cytosolic calcium. To examine the possibility that CADPR is involved in a calcium-dependent processes of ABA signal transduction, an elegant assay system was developed to measure ABA-dependent gene expression in tomato hypocotyl cells. Using rapid micro-injection system, the cells were injected with ABA-inducible genes RD29 from Arabidopsis fuses to the expression marker GUS. The hypocotyl were then incubated with ABA. ABA-dependent genes expression was seen after 2 days, indicating that functional ABA signal transduction pathway was present in these cells, which is shown in figure 1A. This assay system was then used to test effect of putative agonistic and antagonistic of the signal transduction pathway leading to gene expression. 1,2-diglycerol, that is DAG. Diglycerol, DAG, has unique functions as a basic component of membranes and intermediate in lipid metabolism and a key element in lipid-mediated signaling. Cell membranes are the primary site in plants, which perceive a large number of stimuli. Phospholipases are the principal enzymes which mediates the membrane lipid remodeling as they catalyze the initial step of phospholipid breakdown and generate multiple lipid derived second messengers. Phospholipase C, that is PLC, has been recognized as an important group of lipid hydrolyzing enzymes in the plants and animals. In plants, PLC class has been subdivided into a well-studied phosphatidyl inositol specific PLCs, PIPLCs, and recently identifying phosphatidyl choline, that is PLC, PLC group, PIPLC, act upon the specific substrate. PIP2 at a glycerophosphate ester linkage of membrane phospholipids and leads to generation of secondary messenger such as diglycerol, DAG, and inositol 1,4,5 triphosphate. According to the model established in animal system, DAG remains attached to the membrane and activates protein kinases C, PKC, while IP3 is released into the cytoplasm where it binds to ligand-gated calcium ion channels and causes the release of Ca2+ from the intracellular reservoirs. However, this model seems to be inconsistent in plant system, as the level of PIP2 in plant membrane is lower than in animals. Plant cells lack IP3 receptors and equivalent of animal PKC. Instead, the phosphorylated products of DAG and IP3, diglycerol phosphate and hexacase phosphate, that is IP6, have been speculated to function as second messenger in plants. Several PLC members have been implicated in different abiotic stresses triggered signaling events in a number of plant species. Figure shows the pathways of DAG. In figure 1, it is an overview of PLC signaling pathways in plant. PIPLC hydrolyzes into IP3 and DAG. In plants, IP3 is converted to P6 by inositol phosphatase kinases, which binds to IP6 receptors and lead to release of calcium ion from the reservoir. Hence, IP6 act as secondary messenger in signaling pathways. DAG, apart from PIPLC, is also produced by the hydrolytic activity of NPC and PC or P. DAG produced by PIPLC and NPC activity can be converted to its phosphorylated product PA, that is phosphatidic acid, by DAG kinases. Calcium ion and PA act as a signaling molecule in different signaling pathways such as abiotic stresses, biotic stresses, hormone signaling, phosphate starvation, and plant development to produce favorable responses to plant. Figure 2 shows model depicting PLC functions during polarized pollen tube growth and elongation. During pollen tube growth, PI45P2 and PIPLC accumulate at the pollen tubes. Tip, PIPLC hydrolyzes PI45P2 into IP3 and DAG. IP3 or IP6 leads to release of calcium ions from cellular stores. Calcium ion oscillation participates in actin remolding and microtubules recognition by regulating the ABPs, actin binding proteins, for example, fibrin, villin, profilin. On the other hand, IP45P2 interacts with ABPs and suppress their activity, thereby participate in acting remodeling and pollen tube growth. Inositol triphosphate. Inositol triphosphate or inositol 1,4,5 triphosphate, also commonly known as triphospho-inositol, abbreviated by ENCP3 or ENC3P, IP3, together with diglycerol, DAG, is a secondary messenger molecule used in signal transduction and lipid signaling in biological cells. While DAG stays inside the membrane, IP3 is soluble and diffuses through the cell. It is made by hydrolysis of phosphatidyl inositol 4,5 biphosphate, PIP2, a phospholipid that is located in plasma membrane by phospholipase C, PLC. Increase in the intracellular calcium concentration are often result of IP3 activation. When a ligand bind to G protein coupled receptor, that is GPCR, that is coupled to GQ heteromeric G protein, the alpha subunit of GQ can bind to and induce activity in the PLC isoenzyme PLC3 beta, which result in the cleavage of PIP2 into PI3 and DAG. If a receptor tyrosine kinase, that is RTK, is involved in activating the pathways, the isoenzyme PLC gamma has tyrosine residues that can become phosphorylated upon activation of an RTK, and this will activate PLC gamma and allow to cleave PIP2 into DAG and IP3. This occurs in cells that are capable of responding growth factors such as insulin, because the growth factors are the ligands responsible for activating the RTK. IP3 is a soluble molecule and capable of diffusion through the cell cytoplasm to the ER or the sarcoplasmic reticulum, SR, in the case of muscles cells. Once it has been produced by the action of PLC, once at the endoplasmic reticulum, IP3 is able to bind to INS3P receptors, that is INS3PR, on the ligand-gated calcium channel that is found on the surface of endoplasmic reticulum. The binding of IP3 to INS3PR triggers in heart muscle cells. This increase in calcium ion activates the ryanodine receptor operated channels on the SR, result in further increases in calcium ion through a process known as calcium induced calcium release. IP3 may also activate calcium ion channels on the cell membrane indirectly by increasing the intracellular calcium ion concentration. Evolution has adopted positively charged calcium as the primary signaling element of cells. Calcium is one of the principal second messengers for functioning as a central node in the overall signaling web and plays an important role in providing stress tolerance to plants. Analysis of calcium ion in dynamics has demonstrated its signaling role in the plant cells in response to a wide array of environmental cues. In general, the stress leads to increased cytosolic calcium ion, which initiate the stress signal transduction pathways for the stress tolerance. Calcium ion is the most tightly regulated ion within all membrane-bound organisms and bind to several proteins to effect change in localization, association, and function. It is now clear that calcium signaling affect almost every aspect of the cellular metabolism of living organism. In fact, an direct increase in calcium ion cytosine in plant is mediated by increase in intracellular concentration of other second messengers such as cyclic GMP, cyclic AMP, and IP3 in response to stimuli. This elevation of calcium ion concentration in cytoplasm is found to be key event in the plant cell for transduction of various signals to biological effect. Figure shows calcium channels. Without special signaling, intracellular calcium ion concentration is low due to ion pump calcium ion ATPase in the plasma membrane and ER and sodium and calcium ion exchangers in the plasma membrane. When cytoplasmic calcium ion rises, neighboring calcium channels are activated progressively and their opening leads to calcium wave. This is an example of positive feedback. To summarize this module, we have studied three main classes of secondary messengers, namely cyclic nucleotide, inositol triphosphate, and calcium ions. We have also studied different types of secondary messenger in plants and their function in signaling pathways. We came to know that these secondary messengers not only help to pass the signals but also helps in amplify the strength of signals. Thank you.